workout. As you saw, it's shoulders and biceps. Today is considered a heavy day, low reps, so I try to push the weight pretty heavy. My first exercise was the lateral raises. I definitely had to warm my shoulders up. They're my weakest point in my body. I think my shoulders are what needed the most work when I was starting this, and I think will need the most work. First time I get on stage, I think one of my critiques from all the judges will be to build up my shoulders still. So I know that's a spot that I always have to continue to work hard on. So I warmed up with some 10-pound dumbbells with the lateral raises, and then I've worked up to 15. I really try to keep my form right while going heavy, and I believe I did 12 reps with each set. It was 12 to 15, and I went 12. Do you want to get him to sign in that?
It's core fitness, core fitness would be perfect. You guys coming down for the Bros versus Pros?
Well, we were just talking about that. Wish we could. We're flying out first thing Sunday.
Oh, okay. Where you guys come? Where you guys originally from?
Indiana.
Okay. Okay. Cool.
I won a prize in Jamaica for doing the most lateral raises by the pool. I beat two guys. If I go to 15, I start to I start to lose my form and my elbows bend. So I was pretty happy with that. Dumbbell press again. It's I feel like I'm really weak at this exercise. I only went up to 30-pound dumbbells, and I had to have my husband spot me for two or three of my sets. Again, I just have to continue to push heavy with those to really build the shoulders and build my strength.
There you go. First one's hardest. There you go. You got this. Come on. You got this. Keep going. Come on, almost there. A few more. I'm gonna breathe on the way up. Come on, breathe it out, breathe it out. Push it, push, push. That's you. Two more. You gotta do the work here. This can help. There you go. That's all you. I'll try to give you one more. I'll help you on this one. Just press as hard as you can. Press. Nice. Lock. Nice. Good job.
You make me work hard.
Same way. Come on, you got this. There we go. All the way down. Come on. You got this one. Come on, go ahead. Dig deep. Come on. That's all you. Look. This one's gonna be all you. Come on. Press it. I'm gonna do it for you. There you go. Alright, so that was all you.
I got one more after that.
Okay.
Thank you. I want to go heavy. Okay. I was happy that I was able to press 8 reps with the 30s on my own with no spot. That's just a confidence builder. You have to be able to do those sort of things because you're not always going to have a spot around. So you got to know what your limit is and how to dump the weight properly. So I was happy that I was able to do that. The next exercise moves right on to biceps. was one of my favorites, was the barbell curl.
It's usually a cardinal rule that you don't curl in a squat rack, but this gym has more squat racks than any other gym I know, and I'm the only one training. And it's my gym, so I'm gonna curl in the squat rack. And again, I don't recommend doing curls in a squat rack at any other gym, but you know, I was the only one working out today, and we've got plenty of squat racks to go around, so I felt comfortable curling in the squat rack. I love this movement because I feel strong, and I feel like my form is pretty good. I don't, you know, swing my hips and I don't swing my arms to get momentum too much. I try to control the weight up and down, and I really wanted to push heavy with these because it was only 8 to 10 reps, but I think 65 pounds was my max. So then I was starting to bring the hips into it and swing the elbows. So 65 for 8 was my max. I was pretty happy with that. It was pretty strong. Obviously, if the reps were higher, I'd be a little lower weight. Probably like 50-55 is a good weight for me to rep it out. At the gym in Jamaica, there were more 2.5 pound plates than there were 45s. My last movement was the hammer curls. I do these standing up, sitting down. Today I did them standing up to work on my core. I like these movements, but they, for some reason, sometimes hurt my forearms, so maybe it's building my forearm, I don't know. But I probably could have gone heavier with these today, now that I'm thinking about it. I should have gone heavier. I did 20 pounds for 12, so 24 singles. So I'll make a note in my book that next week I should move up to 25s, definitely. Those are the things that I have to take note of and, you know, look back at my workout and see, did I push hard enough? Did I have anything left in the tank?
Second half of cardio later on tonight. Take a break for a little bit. Split it up. Probably do like a nice run outside. It'll be nice and it'll be a little cooler. It was a little hotter today, running outside. So looking back right now, I could tell you that I did everything to my potential except for the last exercise probably. Could have went up. And that was it. And I started my morning with a run outside. It was beautiful out, so I did 45 minutes of a light jog and walk outside. And like I said, my diet just changed because I'm approaching 7 weeks out. On Saturday, I will be 7 weeks out. Tomorrow will be 49 days, but who's counting? PJ just switched up my diet a little bit, the rotation. I'm on a ketogenic diet. Instead of doing 2 days of fat, 1 day of protein veggies, 3 days strictly protein and veggies, 1 day of fat. Today I get fats. I was actually woke up this morning. I was like, ooh, I get peanut butter today. Not even oatmeal or carbs. I'm excited that I get peanut butter and almonds. Give me some energy for the next 3 days. I feel really good. My energy level is up, getting on all my water and all my meals. My workouts still feel strong. I think everything is going to plan. The only thing is I'm just nervous. This is my first prep and I'm nervous that my body is not gonna get to contest shape. I think that's normal. All the people I talk to, all the girls that I talk to, friends, Abby, she's an IFBB pro bikini girl. My friend Rachel, she's just moved into women's physique. Kristin, who just competed at Goals, her first show, they said you have to trust the process. That's what I'm trying to do. I tell PJ all the time, I'm just trusting you. And he knows what he's doing and he wouldn't steer me wrong. For anybody out there that is going through what I'm going through, you're nervous that you're not gonna get there or it's not gonna work, the only thing you can do is listen to your coach and work your butt off. That's what I'm doing. Eating my protein and working my butt off, the results will come. I'm excited to see what next week brings because once I hit 6 weeks out, then it's like, get close. And it's like go time. So we'll see.
Swing!